I will first read from a prepared statement. First and foremost, I want to take this opportunity to address some questions that have remained unanswered. The events of 2010 have been exhaustively reviewed, litigated, and executive judgments have been made. After a lengthy investigation, and as I expected, I have been absolved of any direct wrongdoing. Now, appropriately, I have been returned to a position of senior staff, as it should be, and in the tradition of senior staff appointments, I will take my place at the Hexagon with Calvin Thorncastle and four others, one from each of the six legions. The fault of what transpired on that fateful night in 2010 rests firmly on the shoulders of you, the collective. Now, if you are looking for someone to blame for the events of 2010, I suggest you look inward. Tonight will be an opportunity for you to learn for yourselves why the events transpired as they did, and you will be assigned tasks to complete in this process should you choose to participate. If deemed qualified, you will be dispatched by Thorncastle to do the hands-on research that only you can do, primarily because you caused all this mess in the first place. Legendary truth device technology has been further refined from last year, and as you inadvertently opened a dark portal during your seances last year and thus allowed a dark power to cross over, Thorncastle believes he can reverse this process and grant you access to the other side. Once there, you are to learn as much as possible and to report your findings. I do have a task that I want performed. One of my agents will present each six-person group with a special delivery gift for Thorncastle. Please deliver this gift envelope. Be prepared to present it upon arrival at the Legendary Truth Research Laboratories. You are not to open it or examine its contents in any way. Do I make myself clear?
Yes.
Thank you for the man. Now, that concludes my prepared statement. I am now available to answer any questions you may have. Yes, sir.
Do we know anything about the identity of this dark power that we released last year?
We? No.
Us?
You?
Yes.
Depends on who's been a good puzzle solver. Any further questions? Yes, my dear.
What is your five-year plan to bring the collective back up to how it was before the events of 2010?
Oh, my dear, to reveal a plan, unfortunately, immediately negates a plan. I will assure you that I have one, and that I am very pleased with what I project its outcome to be. Yes, again.
Do we know anything about a manifestation of Mariagana happening after 2008?
To my knowledge, I have not heard of any repeat appearances. That does not mean they have not happened. I have not been informed. Just don't look in any mirrors.
Any other questions? I will say thank you to Mr. Himmel.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I will say, in the interests of transparency, if you would like to discuss the fact that I am here and available for questions, both tonight and perhaps going forward in the future, please feel free to talk to your legions. If there are any questions that pop into your head after you leave, give them to someone else. Good luck, thank you, and try not to screw anything up.
Well, as he informed us tonight, we have a pretty strong and serious mission for Dr. Thorncastle. He is actually going to dispatch each of you into six-person groups. You will be delivered with a new prototype device. That's what's going to happen when you leave this theater into the next room. With the device, you'll be actually use it to navigate through the investigative field out in New York. It'll give you direction. It'll give you timing. It'll also give you identification. With that, we will be able to actually put you into the investigation at certain critical points. You'll actually interact with some of our field agents. You will actually use some other technology devices being prototyped by Legendary Truth, and you'll be able to use it to learn some of the clues that are critical to this investigation. as we've always said, investigating within the legendary truth world, the paranormal is very serious. It comes with a risk and danger. Don't take that at all light, because for us, it is important that we have to do this to find out what best mostly can happen in the way of the paranormal is to investigate it, learn as much as we can so we might potentially, you know, correct it or hopefully foresee it in the future. So with that, I'm gonna ask some questions about tonight's experience. If you guys have any questions about tonight, what we're gonna do, and I'm gonna step out of story here now, to talk about the technology that we are gonna give you. It basically is a prototype lanyard that has a series of different types of functions on it. When you make your way, basically when you start, after you come out of here, you'll run through, first you'll sign the paperwork that we need you to sign. If you choose not to sign it, we hate to say that you won't be able to do the investigations tonight. But if you're able to just go ahead and make the signatures, we'll move you over to the second table, which is registration. Registration will ask a quick thing, your name, we'll actually register the device to you so we know you have the device. At the same time, it will be able to lock your six-person group into a team of investigators, and we'll give you basically a start time. It'll tell you when your investigation starts. Once your investigation starts, it's about a 40 to 45 minute investigation from beginning to end. Now, your investigation start time might be 20 minutes from now, might be 30 minutes from now, might even be 40 minutes from now. So you have some time. Nothing will happen between the start time and when you leave here. You can go get some dinner if you want, go do something, catch a ride or something. So you definitely have time. So that gives you the opportunity to kind of, but once you start your investigation, it'll be, you know, from beginning to end about 40 to 45 minutes. The other thing about the device, it actually has a range only within New York. So when you leave here, you'll be out of the investigative field range, and you'll have to make your way back over into New York for it to actually pick up the device and be able to message you. So if your investigation time is about maybe, you know, 7:80 or something. It'll sleep. You know, you want to get over there about 10 minutes prior, so the devices can be picked up by our network and then be able to message you from there. Now, as you make your way within the investigative field, you're going to see lights on the device. It actually uses that to be able to signify where you need to be, and our field agents are able to capture you and bring you into our quarantine areas. So with that, like I said, make sure that your lights are working when you get out there. And if not, it doesn't matter so much critically, because the six-person team all have the device themselves. Now, the other thing that's a little bit critical too, that you might ask, well, why is my light changing and your light not? Theirs aren't synced together in the group. You are basically synced to the network. So whenever the network picks you up, I might pick you up a few minutes after I pick you up. So that means you might get the signal first before she does. That doesn't mean that you're not gonna get it. It's just if you're in your group, somebody might get it first, the rest of your team might get it a little bit later. Our direction to you guys is that once your team gets it, you guys can proceed as individuals, as a group, I'm sorry, into the next location. Not worried, because all of you are given the same instructions on this test. Okay, make sense? When you have the device, there are buttons on the bottom of it. You'll see a little button bar. I don't have the device, sorry. That's my tag. The bottom of it, it actually gives you the ability to light. So it has a readout. You can read it out by spinning it this way, or it definitely flips the display if you pick it up this way. So you can read it and give it the instructions. But if you need to see it, because of course it's dark out there, the buttons in the bottom will actually light the display for you. From that point, you only want to push that front button. Now, if you hold the button on for too long, you turn the thing off. You turn off the network. So basically, if you just hold it and turn the light on, you're fine. But if you hold it for a period of time, it'll turn it off. So try not to do that. But again, if yours gets turned off, not so critical, as long as you stay together with your group. Okay, any questions about this device that we're going to give you guys? Okay, from that, we flipped some things around for a few of you who were here last night. We're going to send you guys off. This will actually be able to dispatch you quicker into the investigation field. Nobody can start their investigation immediately from when the time is set. So from that, I'm gonna start over here and see, can we get six people? You guys have, first of all, do we have a six person group already? We have some mixers.
We got six right here.
We got one group for six? Okay, one of you guys come up. We'll get you over here by the door. Again, we'll tell you this, it doesn't matter the order, because everybody's gonna see the experience, the waist gauge, once your experience starts. Everybody will go through to the edge here.